Well, that one's purple. Exactly. That's our premium.
What does that mean?
That it makes it cost more.
For the same coverage.
That's what makes it premium.
That doesn't make sense, does it?
No. But it is premium.
I'd just go with consumer cell.
Yeah, the same. Get the exact same coverage as the nation's leading carrier, starting at $20. Consumer cell.
I was thinking about going back to school to get my master's.
I just saw something that said you could do it in a year for like 11. Hmm.
Order 11? Yes, you're 11.
11 on the master's in the right place.
It'll be 11 even late.
Really?
Who's all around us?
Some things are too obvious to be a coincidence.
Tell me this.
What?
Tell me already. I heard you. No, I heard you. I heard you. And see, look, playing this on the plate cools it down, though. It's not so hot hearing you holding it, right?
Yet not accept any guilt for it.
He told her the kidnappers were caught. college students making their way across the country.
Psychology majors from Berkeley University in California. And they decided to kidnap kids starting on the West Coast, moving east. And we've been tracking this group of people and trying to catch them.
So you're telling her a big lie?
Yes.
Say he knew the kidnappers told her they were drop off money, but she wasn't allowed to tell anyone, or else they'd kill him.
And then they say, keep your mouth shut. Don't say anything about what we're telling you, and you're going to get some money.
Oh, but he knew that's why she'd been lying to the police. Is she buying this?
Yeah. She was looking at me intently. She was leaning forward. And I said, so where is this place? And she goes, well, it's in the woods. There's an abandoned building there, and there's a big creek. I said, man, that's excellent. We're not going to go there, and we're not going to look. I said, just one last thing, Michelle. Where is this abandoned building? So she just leaned forward, and she was looking down at the ground, and she just never said another word.
That was it. Another detective who was in the room broke the silence.
That person said to me, I think she might be lying. And she merely jumped up, said, charge me or I'm leaving, and she walked out.
And with that, the interview was over. It was hardly a bust. Michelle had changed her story once again, and she played along with Detective Lewis's kidnapper story.
No innocent, truthful mom would be going with this story.
5 days after that interview, investigators arranged to speak with Michelle again. So far, she'd only spoken to male detectives. This time, they sent a woman to talk to her.
And it was sort of a last resort.
Mary Robillard was a detective with the Middlesex County Prosecutor's Office, a rarity at the time.
In a very large all-male department, there were three of us.
Did you have a kind of strategy going in?
Yes, I did. The FBI had suggested that I find a toy of Timmy's and put it on the table between us and play with it to make her uncomfortable.
She arrived at Michelle's house accompanied by two male officers. From the moment Michelle entered the door, they were taken aback. What was her demeanor like?
Hostile. Hostile from the get-go. In fact, she was chilling. I worked with all kinds of suspects, all kinds of witnesses over the years, and she literally made the hair stand up on my arm.
And as soon as Mary walked into the house, she noticed something that didn't seem right.
On the right-hand side on the way in was a stairway banister, and it was being stripped. All the varnish and everything was off of the paint cans were there. And I thought it was odd that her child was missing for a couple of weeks, and she was, I commented to her on the banister.
What did she say was wrong with it?
She just said it had to be done.
Did you think something had happened with that banister that she was trying to cover up?
Certainly the thought occurred to me that it could have been an accidental fall, that he could have been pushed. There were a number of possibilities.
Mary and Michelle then left the two officers and moved into the dining room where they could be alone. Did you find a toy, as the FBI suggested?
I did. She never looked at it, never said a word about it, just was continually hostile.
Do you think maybe she was getting tired of sort of, you know, playing the role of suspect?
I'm sure she was. I would have been tired of it if I'd been in her shoes. However, if my son were missing, I would probably be more cooperative.
The interview continued with Michelle giving one-word answers. And then Mary says Michelle started laughing.
I said, Michelle, why are you laughing? I'm trying to find my son. And that was enough. I pushed her too far. She exploded. She got up and ran out of her house, uttering an expletive. She dropped an F-bomb on the way out.
Wow. Do you think there was any way that her laughter was nervous laughter and it was misinterpreted?
Certainly it could have been, yes. But that was not my gut feeling at the time. It was disarming.
What was her response when you asked her if she had anything to do with Timmy's disappearance?
That's about the time she left her and discovered her and thinking of something I didn't do. That's at the end of the interview, so she told her the book.
The other officers went after Michelle and brought her back. She was done talking.
She slammed the door in my back. We were out of there.
Even though they had no physical evidence to prove it, law enforcement now believed Michelle was somehow responsible for her son's death. They just couldn't get past her lack of emotion at losing her son, and her ever-changing story about what happened to him. And there was one more thing. The day after Timmy went missing, Police had given Michelle a polygraph test. Not an uncommon thing for parents of missing children.
When she was taken an FBI polygraph, it was deceptive.
She failed. And a few weeks later, they gave her another polygraph. She failed that one too. But those results weren't admissible in court. And the few things they found in Timmy's remains, like his shoes and that mysterious blue blanket, didn't seem to lead anywhere. So the case grew cold. People went on with their lives. Then, a few years later, Michelle was suddenly back in the news.
In New Jersey, her young son's murder made headlines, and now the woman, once rumored to be a suspect, has disappeared under mysterious
circumstances. Michelle kidnapped? What is going on here?
Coming up.
Michelle's brother says that he found Michelle's car empty, engine still running.
Where was Michelle?
Don't think it's like the same people that took Timmy, the